Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you a super simple way to build an amazing newsletter agent. Let me show you a couple of examples. First of all, here is an example about American tariffs. Another example is here where it has a bit more detail, where it has information from the real time and again talks about how consulting is changing with AI. You can create this with the same agent. So I'm going to show you how to exactly do that. So let me just start walking through that whole process. First of all, we have the chat messages received. You can bring out the first agent, which is the research agent. Now, something that I've done in the research agent is very specifically find real-time information. Most of the times that when you're using agent, you are just using an AI model and then using some other tool and just getting the information. That does not make sense. If you're writing a newsletter, you need real-time information. And if you want to utilize an agent to do that, you have to give an option on how can agent do that. So very simply, here is how the prompt looks like. And let me just zoom in a bit so you can see better. Here is a simple example where you are an expert in journalistic research. And I have chosen very carefully with the prompt that I am looking for the research agent to be a journalistic expert to get details on different angles about the information. Then I will explain how you have to impact the perception of the news. We are taking the chat input, which is the input given by the user about what kind of a newsletter that you want to create. And then again, you have access to the following tools. Perplexity API is something we have given them as access. Press and enter here. So you can see use Perplexity API tool at least 3 times to get different details around the topic. Now, how do you set this up? Very simply, if you're using it for the first time, just go ahead and pick up a block and select an AI agent. And you can go ahead and start building that up. Now, we don't need to do that. So I'm just going to delete this step. But coming back here, you have an option where we have a tool available. This is the Perplexity API. Now, I can add multiple tools from here. I have just chosen the HTTP request tool because if I search Perplexity, that is not supported directly by anything, but I have just put up an API call here. Here is how it looks like. Very simply, you have the description, you have the URL, you have the basic authentication, which has my API key that is input there, and all the inputs. The only thing I've changed is the body. I have a JSON placeholder here, which is user topic. This topic is being triggered by the agent. The only thing that I've changed here is the content. So if you see the content here, which is user topic, this is going to come from the agent itself. The way you do that is just put anything within a placeholder, which is curly braces, and then display this is the topic that the user is looking for. I've described what is the placeholder for, what is the system, and everything else. With this, as you can see, it runs 3 times as described. My agent goes ahead and asks 3 different questions to Perplexity API and gives me the response. And on the left hand side, you can also see the response getting, right? So run number two has different question, run number 3 has a different question. And we also get a different kind of a response in the output. So you get a different kind of output response, which can then be used as we go ahead, which is then used by the agent to bring all of this information together. This is probably one of the most coolest steps with the agent. I can describe exactly what tool you should use, exactly how many times you should use that, and also how should you use that. Once that is done, I've got all the research available for me. So the research agent takes all of this information and converts it into a single item. The first time that I ran this, it came as this. Now, another option, we obviously need to create the newsletter also. So that's where we come back to our create and send agent. Again, it's the same kind of an agent, but one major difference here is that I am using the Anthropic chat model here, which is the Claude API. Why is that? Because when choosing a model for a specific agent, you need to understand that every model has its own plus and minuses, right? So very simply, OpenAI works in a lot of places, but for writing and coding, Claude is still unbeatable no matter what. So I've just gone and input a Claude 3.5 Sonnet, connected with my API, and just brought it here. Now, if I come back here, you can see, again, I have created a very simple prompt on explaining how I want this to be returned. Craft a fun and professional newsletter. I've given it the topic, which is input by the user. Information is coming from our research agent. If you can see the research agent node, all of this information is coming from the Perplexity API, sending all that data to ChatGPT, bringing that information in a single place. So all the 3 queries get merged and gets you the final information available here. Then it takes that information, and then I have also given it a place where how I exactly want the newsletter to look, because we want a specific HTML kind of a response. Now again, a couple of things that I've added here, created with 3 major headings, details, sub-details in around 5 sentences, and then 3 major bullets related to headings in an easy to digest format. Again, I've kept a couple of examples of what should be the reading level, there should not be any adjectives, and etc. Again, the goal of this The goal is to make sure it does not feel like that it is AI generated, because you can also use this whole workflow and actually sell this to someone who wants an automated newsletter generation. You can update the topics, you can update the reasons and everything else. After doing all of this, you technically just have one more tool to add here. You can send a newsletter. Newsletter sending is simple. I added a tool which is with a Gmail account and defined all the information here. Now, one thing that I've done here is, because I'm using the same Claude model, I've also gone and described what kind of the subject of newsletter looks like. I've defined it as this particular string and also the message and the HTML that should come from the agent. Always make sure that when you are describing it, you're using this particular kind of expression language. So you have from AI and then describe the subject line, subject to newsletter, and describe what you want there and what would be the default value. Again, all the options are already available here and you can input it as you want. Now, once all of that is done, let's actually test it out and see how it looks. So let's refresh, and I'm just going to write, how is American tariff changing the world, right? And that's a simple one, right? I want to see how it comes out, going through the tools, bringing that together. The model is asking perplexity three times what kind of a different options you are looking at. You can make it 5, 6, 7 as many times as you want, so that you get different kind of viewpoints, you get different kind of information based on the query. Remember that when you're using a tool like Perplexity, or when you're using a tool about anything else, the agent is trying to get multiple kind of an information, and if you're only using it once, then doesn't make any sense, because you'll get very limited information and then your newsletter does not look great. So again, very simply, we have got the information available from here. We have got final information that is being run, and finally this is going to send. And one thing, if you don't know, you can go ahead and see the logs here, which is super cool, because you can actually see what did every part of the agent respond and select which option to go forward. You should have probably got an email, and as you can see, in the same exact format with a great headline, we have got the perfect newsletter created, right? Again, want to learn more about tariffs? Again, all of these things can be added as a rule, and we can put all of those things a bit more in detail, but this comes out fairly well. Like, imagine, like, this has got real-time information, right? You have shopping costs more money now, etc. Think of it like an extra fee on toys. It's explaining this country sell a lot of things to America are not happy when you make it harder to sell their stuff, they sell less. Explaining it in a simple and easy digestible format. I have obviously kept the reading level to grade 4, that's why it's showing this in a more, like, you know, kiddish way. Obviously you can go ahead and change it to become more professional and put all of those settings. You can also create a user interface on top of this to allow someone to generate a newsletter like a second, and just you're off to the races. This whole template will be available in the description, and if you liked the video that you watched just now, please subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, it helps me out a lot, and I would love to see you in the next one.